In this video, we're talking about specific heat capacity. The definition of specific heat capacity and the symbol that we're going to use is a lowercase s, and it is the amount of energy that it takes to raise the temperature of 1 gram of a substance by 1 degree Celsius. Now, every substance has a specific heat capacity: aluminum, water, gasoline, what have you. And however much energy it takes for 1 gram of that substance to have its temperature raised by 1 degree Celsius, that's its specific heat capacity. And you can look these up. There are tables of specific heat capacities for different substances. The units of specific heat capacity are joules over grams times degrees Celsius, or joules over grams Kelvin. These are the most common. You could have calories on top, but for the most part, we'll use joules. And it doesn't matter, degrees Celsius or Kelvin, you do it the same way. There's no difference between these two. Now, the only specific heat capacity I will ask you to memorize or to put in your card is that of water, 4.184 joules per gram degrees Celsius, same, or 4.184 joules per gram Kelvin. Memorize that one. If you need any other specific heat capacity, I'll give it to you. Now, one way we can use the specific heat capacity of a substance is with this equation here. Memorize this equation. Q is equal to M times S times delta T. Here, Q is how much energy is transferred into or out of a substance. M is the mass of that substance in grams. Oh, units of energy are joules. The capital J stands for joules, and that's the unit that we use for energy. And S, of course, is the specific heat capacity. Usually we just say specific heat, we omit the word capacity. And its units are joules per gram degree Celsius or joules per gram Kelvin, same thing. And delta T, it's the change in temperature. Remember this, it's always the final minus the initial temperature. And it's in degrees Celsius or Kelvin, it doesn't matter the temperatures here. Now, the final temperature, it can be higher than the initial temperature, in which case something is being heated up, or it can be lower than the initial temperature. If T final is lower than T initial, that means that the object is being cooled. Now here, the mass has to be positive. Specific heat capacity always has to be positive, but our delta T can be negative or positive depending upon the size of the final temperature to the relative to the initial temperature. If delta T is negative, Q is negative. All that means, if Q is negative, it just means that energy is lost by the object, by the substance. If Q is positive, that means that energy is gained by the substance. So the instance when Q is positive will be when delta T is positive, which means the final temperature is higher than the initial temperature, which means that the object is its temperature is rising, which means that it's gaining thermal energy, and that's what positive Q means. If the final temperature is lower than the initial temperature, that means it's being cooled off and it's losing thermal energy. That's what negative Q means. So let's look at a couple of examples here. Suppose we need to calculate how much energy is needed to raise the temperature of this many grams of water from this temperature to this temperature. All we do is we plug into our Q equals MS delta T equation, because, okay, the question asked how much energy. Energy is Q. So M is the mass, so we put this in here. S is the specific heat capacity. Now notice I did not give you the specific heat capacity here because it's water and I ask you to memorize that. If it's any other substance, I would give you the specific heat capacity. And I give you two temperatures, final and initial, from this to this. That means this is final, this is initial. So our delta T will be final minus initial, which ends up being 52.2 degrees Celsius or Kelvin. Plugging in, we get about 100,000 joules, or in terms of kilojoules. I didn't specify the units here, so I gave them both really. So all I did to go from joules to kilojoules is divide by 1,000. It gave me 100 kilojoules. Three significant figures. This guy has four. This has four. But when you do the subtraction to one place past the decimal, you only get three significant figures. Let's do another example. Now, okay, we see that we can calculate the specific heat of a substance. if we know Q, if we know M, and we know delta T. So it takes this many joules of energy, the energy is Q, to raise a temperature of this many grams, so this is M, the mass, of some metal from this temperature to this temperature. So that means this is our final temperature, 49.8 degrees Celsius, and this is our initial temperature, 25.8 degrees Celsius. So if we plug in here, Q equals mass times specific heat times delta T. But now, because we want to find the specific heat capacity, we just rearrange this equation, cross multiply, divide through by M times delta T. Make sure you guys see how I got this form of it right here. S is equal to Q over M times delta T. I just rearranged this. Plugging in, the energy is Q, positive. M is our mass, 89.42 grams. Our delta T is final minus initial temperature. And when you plug in, you get, because this has three sig figs, and our delta T also has three sig figs, we end up with 0.336 sub 8 joules per gram degree Celsius, or rounding 0.337 joules per gram degree Celsius for the specific heat capacity.